follow them back to Greece. Where we last left our South Balkan friends, things were looking pretty good. Persia had stopped its invasions, allowing Greece's culture and economy to finally boom in peace. You know what they say, new autonomy, new me. Without Persia as an existential threat, Greece, and particularly the city-state of Athens, would enter its golden age, leading to the prominence of philosophers like Socrates and Plato. If Confucius was the family athlete that got straight A's, Socrates was the rebellious kid that went to art school. Hey, at least he was more fun. Smartest fellas on the block, these guys would ponder the complexities of life and educate others from the Mediterranean world. An Athenian student on break could even take in a show. As Athens' version of Broadway featured playwrights like Aeschylus, Sophocles, and Euripides. It's just too bad they didn't have smartphones, because I'm sure these art-enthused Athenians would also be checking out the channel's Instagram page. Link is in the description.
That's a good idea, you know?
Needless to say, learning and arts in Athens are at a real high point. Then again, we can just never have nice things. Remember from the last video when Greece's city-states are at war all the time? Sparta didn't forget and for 30 years fought the Athenians until Sparta emerged victorious. Hey, are you okay?
I'm fine!
Unfortunately for the Spartans, they kind of forgot.
There's always a bigger fish.
Seeing as how pretty much all of Greece was as weak as you'd expect to be after three decades of war, not to mention the Athenian plague that killed 25% of its population, Macedon's leader Philip II decided that taking all of Greece would be easier than beating Count Draenor in old-school RuneScape. Just don't forget the stake and hammer. Philip was a swell guy and all, but historians and dictators seem to be a lot more interested in talking about his son, Alexander the Great. You might remember him from the second video in Ancient Egypt, which also feels like it dropped 2,500 years ago. Alexander was renowned for his foreign policy, which involved just making other countries part of your country.
That's a good idea.
Most notably, he conquered Greece's season one antagonist, the Achaemenid Persian Empire. Alexander's military goals were accomplished almost purely out of ego, but establishing a massive empire often has the side effect of rapidly moving people and culture. After Alexander, you'd find Greeks in Egypt, Greeks in Mesopotamia, Greeks in Afghanistan, and even some Greeks in India. Alexander died after the ripe old age of 32, but his generals stuck around, and a lot of these areas would continue to be Greek-influenced in regards to literature, language, and even religion. Coming from the word Hellas, which is what the Greeks called their homeland, this new era of Greek influence on the ancient world would become known as the Hellenistic period, lasting for hundreds of years. That was, of course, until the arrival of another posse of bad boy Mediterraneans, the Romans. But hey, let's not get hasty. Instead, let's take a minute to recap Greece's romp with antiquity. It started off archaic, not saying it wasn't fun, but a foot race done stopped swords from spraying, cause Perseus the Rice wasn't nice to the Greeks, and he won a slice on our mainland since last week. Athenians back then went hard, and they beat the Rice back at the Bay of Marathon, but 10 years later, they brought some other ships, come to topple Sparta after my believer Sparta won't quit. So now we're moving on to classical Greece, no drama, just philosophers are mad, all the sun flee, but it's about to get bleak, cause Sparta ain't weak, and they went to war with Athens till they all got beat. Philip II, don't get it wrong. He brought the hammer on the Greeks from the man of Macedon, man. His son Alex became the new leader. He invaded Persia, Egypt, and Mesopotamia. Even got to India till he wound up there. But no stress, he left the land to all of his friends. And now, roaming around for 300 years. Swarm of Greeks in every town, get Hellenistic in here, We're gonna take a closer look into Greek culture with our next episode, so stay tuned for the final installment of the channel's Greek trilogy. Just try not to compare it to Lord of the Rings. Thanks a lot for watching, and if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe. It really helps me out.
Thank you.
Until next time, peace out. Maybe I could have used a better choice of words.